Today we are going to discuss about the P Thomson experiment. This is the experimental setup of P Thomson experiment, which consists of a discharge tube in which there exists a cathode. Here this has been accelerated with maximum amount of voltage so that the electrons will be ejected from this cathode, and they are being allowed to as a parallel beam by making use of these two slits. And now these narrow beam of electrons will be incidented on an gold foil which is of very few microns. Now these electrons which are being incidented on the gold foil will penetrate into them because it is of very micro thin order, and it has since the electrons have been accelerated with the maximum of energy. Now these electrons are being scattered in all the directions, isn't it? And this diffraction pattern of electrons which are coming from a gold foil are being recorded on a photographic film. The entire setup is being placed in a vacuum chamber so that these electrons will does not collide with the air molecules. Isn't it? So to prevent that, vacuum setup has been inserted here. So the if you develop the photographic film, we'll come across with the diffraction pattern of the electron beams coming from the gold foil. See, this is some of the description given by description regarding this P Thomson experimental setup. The experiment is performed in which the electrons are being accelerated from 10,000 to 50,000 volts. In this experiment, the electrons are being generated, isn't it, by considering analogous to X-ray tube, isn't it, by a diffraction pattern. The diffraction pattern is observed is being obtained by only when the waves have been associated with the particle. Hence, Thomson explains the concept of matter waves. Why? Because as we know, according to de Broglie hypothesis, moving particle is being associated with matter waves. So if electrons are being accelerated with a maximum energy, isn't it, and they are being incidented on the film, isn't it, so that we can calculate the wave nature associated with that moving particles, isn't it? Thomson have proved experimentally these electrons are being accelerated from the cathode, and they are being passed through two slits which makes them as a narrow beam. And now these narrow beam of X-rays are being allowed to fall on a gold foil which is very few microns. See, these are the beams of X-rays which are coming from the cathode ray. They will incidented on the thin film of gold foil. Now these electrons which are being incidented here will be scattered in all the directions, isn't it? And now these scattered electrons, electron beam which are being scattered from the thin foil will forms a diffraction pattern, and that is being recorded on a photographic film. See, here is the photographic film which consists of a concentric circles here like this. This experiment is being completely concluded, is being concluded that this pattern is due to electrons and not due to X-rays. We can conclude the pattern is obtained due to electrons only, since the X-rays are not being affected by electric and magnetic fields. See, how the diffraction pattern is observed. So this has been explained by Bragg's X-ray diffraction technique. So if you can consider the gold atoms, so the gold atoms have been arranged in a regular periodic way like this, isn't it? And now if you join all the atoms, isn't it, with an imaginary line, isn't it, you will come across with a plane 1. So take another plane, isn't it, joining all these atoms of gold atoms of a gold foil, and you will come across with another plane 2. Now let us suppose there exists a distance between these two planes which have been called called as interplanar spacing, represented by D. Now the rays are being incidented, the electron beam is being incidented from the cathode ray tube onto the gold foil. So the beams are being incidented as IB1 and IB2. IB1 and IB2. Now these rays, the first incidented ray IB1 will incident on the first plane, isn't it, first atom of first plane at O, and again from this it will be gets reflected back. Now the second beam IB2 will be incidented onto the atom Y of plane 2, and now it is also been getting reflected back like this. So that here these reflected, the incidented rays and the reflected rays, that is IB1 RB1 and IB2 RB2, which are IB1 and IB2 are incidented rays and RB1 and RB2 are the reflected rays, isn't it? Now these two rays are having a path difference. Geometrically there exists a path difference here. You can calculate the path difference between the incidented and diffracted rays. Now these reflected rays will be gets incidented on a photographic film, isn't it? So that these two rays, reflected rays, that is RB1 and RB2, isn't it, on incidenting onto the photographic film, will constructively gets superposed, so that if they gets constructively interfere, we can calculate the, or we can identify the bright spot, so that we can calculate the diffraction pattern observed, isn't it, from the electron beams. Now see here, geometrically when you extend the RB line, isn't it, onto the second incidented ray, and similarly IB1 ray, isn't it, if you extend here onto the RB2, there exists a path difference here which is given by XY plus YZ. Okay. So the rays which are been incidenting are always in phase and parallel up to the point at which the top beam strikes at a layer at atom O, this one, and the second beam continues to the next layer where it is been scattered by an atom Y. The second beam must travel with the extra path difference. So this is the extra path difference XY plus YZ. These two beams are continue traveling adjacent and parallel. This extra distance, isn't it? See, this additional path difference must be equal to integral multiples of lambda to become in phase, isn't it? We know what is the in phase condition is. Path difference should be equal to n lambda, so integral multiples. See, now if you consider the triangle OXY, here, isn't it, triangle O, X and Y, here, isn't it, so this looks like an right angle triangle in which XY will be an opposite side and OY will be the hypotenuse. So that if you consider the triangle O, X and Y, isn't it, sine theta will be equal to opposite side by hypotenuse, and we should know about sine theta, XY value, so XY is equal to D sine theta. XY is equal to D sin theta. Similarly, when you consider the other triangle OYZ, isn't it? This one, this also looks like an right angle triangle. Here also we have to find YZ value. So here also YZ acts as an opposite side and OY will act as an hypotenuse. So here also from that triangle we can calculate YZ value, which is D sin theta. So now, therefore, the path difference between the incidented and the diffracted beams will be equal to, isn't it, delta will be equal to XY plus YZ, which is equal to 2D sin theta. Okay, D sin theta plus D sin theta. These waves fields are been getting diffracted, will interfere, isn't it, among each other constructively, creating a diffraction pattern on the film or detector. So when the path difference is equal to integral multiples of lambda, this will gives you constructive interference, which is a constructive interference means maximum intensity. So therefore the geometrical path difference, that is 2d sin theta, will be equal to n lambda. So this implies theta is equal to lambda by 2d. Here for smaller angles of theta, why? Because since the gold foil is of very smaller thickness, isn't it, we can consider the angles are very small, so that for smaller angles sine theta is approximately equal to theta, and by substituting n is equal to 1 for first order spectrum, you will get theta is equal to lambda by 2d. Now see, this is the gold foil, and this line will represents the beam of X-rays which are coming and passing through the gold foil without any deviation. So let OC is the undiffracted X-ray beams, and the diffracted there will be some diffracted beams, so that let O and OS isn't line will represents the diffracted beams. Here, isn't it, let us draw the normal to the planes of the gold foil, isn't it, since we have already considered the planes inside this gold foil. Now, this normal, let us consider n is the normal, isn't it, of the planes of the gold foil. Now this normal to the normal, the diffracted rays will make an angle theta, isn't it, so that on either sides, isn't it, you will come across with the theta value here. So R is the radius of concentric circles of patterns of the diffracted beam from the center, and let L is the distance between the gold foil and the film. So now when you consider the triangle OSC here, isn't it? So it looks like a rectangle triangle where tan 2 theta, so this theta and this theta, tan 2 theta will be equal to opposite side, that is SC by adjacent side OC. So R by L. So 2 theta will be equal to R by L, theta is equal to R by 2L. Here also we have considered the angles are very small. Why? Because the film is of very smaller thickness. So that for smaller angles, tan theta is equal to almost equal to theta. So here also you will come across with theta is equal to R by 2L. So previously we got an equation, that is theta is equal to lambda by 2D. And now here we got theta is equal to R by 2L. Now by considering these two equations 1 and 2, R by 2L is equal to lambda by 2D, which implies lambda is equal to RD by L. So where R is the radius of the concentric circles, we can calculate directly, isn't it, by developing the photographic film, and D is the interplanar distance of gold foils, isn't it, and L is the distance between gold foil and the film. So substituting all these values, we'll come across with lambda value, which exactly gets equal with the, isn't it, de Broglie wavelength value. So this confirms the existence of matter waves, isn't it, which has been experimentally verified by G.P. Thomson experiment. So this is one of the other experiment which evidences the existence of matter waves. So previously Davison and Davison-Germer experiment will also prove with a minute difference. Here also G.P. Thomson have also proved the same existence of matter waves, so with a very with an exact value, so that this confirms that the matter waves have a dual nature, isn't it? So thank you.